Within days, the weak, candling ice will become too thin to cross safely on foot, yet not melted enough for canoe passage. The houseboaters must be prepared with all the supplies they need to survive several weeks stuck inside. And Molly, owner of the lake's only bistro boat, is nearly out of fish.
So as you can see, I'm completely out of fish and I have to stock up for the restaurant. I gotta go walk across that ice and I'm really nervous about it.
She must make the trek across the semi-frozen bay to the fish plant now in order to stock her freezers.
The other day, there was someone, he had fallen through in front of our house and my dad ran out with a plank to like save him. And he's really lucky because no one's gonna save you in the middle of that lake. I'm bringing my canoe to get over to the fish plant and I'm gonna try some canoe breakup techniques. I'm gonna push the canoe and kind of like run behind it a little bit and put my weight on the back of it so that if I go through, I can just put my feet in the canoe and I'm not gonna be in the water.
And choosing the safest route across the bay, Molly must look for white patches indicating solid ice and steer clear of dark or candled spots, which could send her into the icy waters below.
Hey!
Hi.
I was hoping to get some fish today, if
yes.
You had anything.
How much would you need?
I was thinking like 17 fillets.
When I showed up to get some fish, Henry was surprised to see me on that ice.
How did you manage to get over here? Did you walk on the ice or did you come across the island?
Oh, I went on the ice. I took the canoe.
I won't do that.
Yeah. And that made me really nervous to go back.
The ice gets soft and then you can actually go through it. Once the ice candelizes, it's easy to go through. Not a good feeling going through.
So anyhow, I'm glad I was able to help you with fish. And if you need any more, you should come by and see me.
Thank you.
But in the meantime, that ice is pretty scary. I don't know if I'd be coming back on that ice anymore after
this
today.
This will definitely be the last trip. I'm glad I could fill my freezer. Thank you.
Okay, that's good. You have yourself a nice day.
You
glad
too.
I was able to help you.
The ice started giving out under my feet. I don't think I picked as good a route as I had on the way there. I started falling through the ice a little bit. My feet started sinking in and I just had to like book it. I was going in if I didn't keep on moving. That is my technique, to move as fast as possible, and I definitely hit myself on the canoe so many times I'm just covered in bruises. It was not a good technique. When I got back from the fish plant, I made up my mind. I am not going back on that ice.
So you're actually, like, you're actually breaking through it.
Like, my whole leg going in on either side. It's really unsettling.